By the end of the video, you'll begin to understand the powerhouse of Blender modifiers. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about introducing the concept of modifiers in Blender by using one of the most powerful modifiers, the Boolean modifier. Starting from a fresh Blender file, I think it's time to take a look at one of the most powerful features of Blender, which is modifiers. Now, you've heard me say this once or twice, so let's introduce modifiers. But before we do that, I want to show you that we've done something that's very modifier-esque, and that's what I'm going to be using to show you what a modifier is. So this cube, we're going to take it into edit mode. We're going to duplicate it, move it out like this, and don't deselect this selection. Remember, we had this here called a Boolean that lets you do an intersection cut and do incredible cuts very easily, as well as unions and intersections. And this here is an incredibly powerful thing. But wouldn't it be even more powerful if that mesh that you've already used, you could then go ahead and move it or edit it in some way? Well, that's what a modifier lets you do. Well, that's what the Boolean modifier lets you do. Let's go ahead back into object mode. Let's grab our cube. Let's duplicate it and move it out like that. So we have two objects here. We have this here, which I'm going to call the cut cube. And then this here, which I'm going to call the root cube. Now, why have I renamed these? I've renamed it more than anything just to make it clear, because the cut cube isn't going to have the modifier in it. The root cube is. So right here, this little wrench, this is the modifier properties. It can also be called the modifier shelf or the stack, and we'll understand why in a moment. So we have an add-on called the Bool tool currently activated, and the Bool tool lets me do something very powerful, which is click this, shift click here, go control numpad minus. Now, what happens if you don't have a numpad? What exactly has just happened here? I'm going to go ahead and undo all that and show you it manually, but in the future, I'm just going to be using the Bool tool. So undoing that, manually speaking, what just happened there is we selected this as our active object. We went over to the add modifiers, and you can see there's a lot here, but what we're interested in is a Boolean operation. Then from here, as you can see, this is very familiar to our Boolean operation in edit mode. You can do object or collections, which is a little bit extra. Here, you can do the drop down, or you can use the eyedropper to select the mesh. As you can see, the outline has already done it. However, you cannot see it right this minute. You could go ahead and just hide the object, or you could grab this object, go over to the object properties, go to viewport display, and change this here to its bounds right there. So this here is what the Boolean modifier lets you do. A modifier is an effect on mesh. Listen to that, an effect on mesh. It's not applied to the mesh. If we go to edit mode right this minute with this cube, you can see the mesh is still there. Okay, however, because it's an effect on the mesh, this lets you edit the effect. So you can move the effect of that's basically applied onto the mesh. It's incredibly powerful. I'm sure just this alone, you can see how incredibly very close it is to parametric modeling, but there is definitely a little bit of caveats to come to it, and we'll get to that in the future. Okay, so that in essence is modifiers. Now let's start talking about just the Boolean modifier, because there's just so much, and every single modifier is different in its own right, but let's talk about the Boolean one now. So we have the Boolean modifier. Right this minute, if you try to move this cube, you can see that that doesn't keep it. So let's go ahead and keep it. And the way we do this is by applying the effect of the modifier to the mesh. So right this minute, you have this here, which is the modifier tools add-on. Or here, you have this apply. Now, just before we apply it, I want to show you what these do here. This is for when you're rendering, if you understand rendering. This is viewport display. From our display, you can see it on and off. And right this minute in edit mode, you don't see it. However, if you want, you can turn it on to see it in edit mode. It can throw you off a bit, so just be careful. And by the way, all of these are in most of the other modifiers as well. Okay, so let's go ahead. Let's apply that modifier. You can see that the cutting object has stayed. And here, our mesh has now been edited. Okay, I'm going to clear our scene here. And let's create ourselves a cube once again. And let's do just quickly showing you how the Bool tool modifier works, because it's a little bit different. Here, the Bool tool, clicking this, shift click, and we can do a different brush, which does all the operations all at once, or you can do an auto, which does all the operations and deletes the mesh that you just cut with. Of course, it doesn't have to be a cut. It could be a union, or it could be an intersection, or it could be a slice, which is just slicing away right here the mesh that you wanted. Okay. Now let's talk about some of the things you've got to keep in mind. So it's only recently that the Boolean modifier has become so powerful. In the past, this right here would have been a nightmare to deal with. This is called coplanar faces. I've mentioned it once before. So let's go ahead. This shift click, control minus, so we get this here. In the past, Booleans used to only be fast, which gave you this quite weird behavior that if you tried to go ahead and move things, it would work, and then out of some reason, all of a sudden it wouldn't work quite how you expected it. And this is when you had coplanar faces, which we get a lot of when we do precision modeling. However, now we have exact Boolean calculation, which basically fixes that problem. Okay, I'm going to turn off this Boolean now. I'm going to delete this cube, bring in a new cube. So duplicating it, bringing it to there. And on purpose, I'm going to go and create a problem here. We're going to go in here. We're going to select all the faces. We're going to go Shift N, and we're going to flip the normals. So right this minute, if we take a look at the normals are inside out. This is something that you have to keep in mind of when you are doing any type of modifier. So if we tried to do a modifier right now, it will not work. Normals are extremely needed to do modifiers. So let's go ahead here. Let's go Shift N, fix our normals. And you can see right there, it's now sorted out. Something else to keep in mind. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to undo all of our things so we can see our cube once again. I'm going to quickly fix the normals that I had all done weird here. You also have to have closed mesh. So I'm going to delete this face here. You would think, sure, that can be able to cut that, right? So shift, click, control, minus. Okay, it's cut it, but you're going to start to have a problem when you start moving this around. All of a sudden, what's going on here? Why is it, surely that would cut it. Is it not working? Just be aware that you can get some quite weird results sometimes when the mesh that you're cutting with is open and isn't closed geometry. Now there is one more to keep in mind. So I'm going to undo this, rebuild this cube here. And the other one to keep in mind, let's turn off our face normals, is scale. This scale of any type of object that you are doing a modifier with or affecting another object with, you should always aim to have this scale at 1. When this scale goes weird, sometimes, not always, when you're doing modifiers, it's going to go a little bit strange. However, now with the exact work, it isn't that bad. But as soon as you start adding more modifiers into it, especially when we're dealing with modifiers that deal with bevels and chamfers and so much more, scale is so important. So make sure that if you do want this to be that size, just go ahead and apply the scale. And then you know that that's not going to be a problem later on and down the line. Okay, now with all the caveats out there, which is closed geometry, scale, and normals, let's talk about the whole idea of modifier stacking. So we have one modifier right this minute on our root cube here that has this object. So let's go ahead and let's create ourselves a sphere. A UV sphere, I'm just going to bring this up on the Y, and let's say that I wanted to join this. Okay, well that's just a shift click, control numpad plus, and that has been joined to the mesh. However, I didn't want this to be like that. I wanted this joint mesh to also be cut away by this Boolean right here. Well, that's a case of ordering the operations. If we take a look here, what we have is the difference, the cutaway, and then the union. What we actually want is the union first, and then the cutaway. And as you can see, then we have exactly what we want. Keep in mind that we still need to apply this, because if you try to move this, it's not going to work. All right, well, with that said, let's go ahead. Let's select this. I'll use apply all this time, and now we can get this here, move it out, as you can see, and the mesh has been created from our Boolean operations. Now let's quickly take a look at modifiers in a little bit more of a real world situation. Down in the description is this file to play about with, so you can follow along. So this here, this entire object, is created just from a cube, which affords me the availability to go in and say, hey, you know what? This right here, I want this to be beveled. And add some beveling, go a bit like that. Let's say that this wants to be 30. There we go, perfect. Go out of edit mode and it has been applied. And all of this is done completely through modifiers. So you can go here, you can view all of the little elements that put it together. Right. So now what I want you to do is in that file, you have this right here. I want you to go ahead and try and create what we created there. So pause right now, give it a go, and I'll show you how to do it right now. So it's basically a case that we have our root cube here, and then we have this cube here. So it's as simple as you think. We're just selecting it and editing it down towards what we're wanting. You want to make sure that you're doing this in the right order so it doesn't really break instantly when you're doing things, because if you were to join that and then cut away, well, you've just cut away what you were trying to join. So what we're wanting to do is add this mesh, and then down here, well, we'll go here and we're going to cut away that one. We will cut away this one as well. And you can see just quite how powerful the Boolean modifier is. And not only that, this can be any type of modifier. It is so incredibly powerful and easy on how to do all of this. And not only that, but keep in mind that all of the mesh is editable. Not only the root object, but the mesh of the modifier itself. So for instance, right here, these two, let's say I didn't want this to go all the way up to the top. Well, I could grab both of them, take it into edit mode. We can go and do a vertex selection of everything. And let's just say we're going to scale this on the Z and bring this just down a bit so there's some clearance. And there we go. We have now just edited the holes without having to do a whole bunch of hassle. And of course, once you have something that you're happy with, you can just export this straight up as an STL and 3D print it, or you can go ahead and apply all the modifiers. Do keep in mind that I'm not saying modifiers are perfect. Nothing beats precision hand modeling. Because when you go ahead and take a close look at this, you're going to see that there can be some problems. So let's take this into edit mode. Let's select everything here, and then let's do our trusty merge by distance. And you can see that 33 vertices have been dealt with. So something that can be quite useful is sometimes to just apply everything, clean up the mesh, and just take a look. Just make sure that it's all looking fine. Maybe do the print tool, check how that's going. And the key thing here is that you know that what the mesh needs is to be defined. From our last video, where we mentioned how 3D printing and how mesh works and how constraints work. Well done for getting through that video. I know it can be extremely daunting the first time you encounter Blender modifiers. I know that me, quite personally, I completely screwed them up for a very long time. Now, if you do get stuck, remember that we have a Discord community that's linked down in the description where you can go ahead and ask any question. And of course, rewatch the video. I do try my best to cover absolutely everything that can go wrong. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome, and it's the reason why I'm able to make these videos right here for everyone. And if you're enjoying these videos that I'm making, and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.